welcome to my channel. Today I'm making chocolate pie. Yeah, chocolate pie's gotta be done. So we've got an Asda all butter pastry case. Yeah, we've got a Tesco double cream. You can use any of these. We've got some 70% chocolate and some milk chocolate chunks. I'm going to measure 200 mils of double cream into my pan. The thing about this recipe is it's easy to remember because all you need to do is have equal quantities of chocolate and cream. It's as easy as that. And I'm going to put 200 in here.
It's always that last bit, isn't it? There we go. Oh, no, not quite.
200 mils. What I'm going to do with that is warm it on the stove top. So I'll be back with you when it's warm. We don't want it to boil, by the way. While the cream is warming on the stove top, I've got it just to the side of me so I can see it. I'm going to start and chop my chocolate up. I don't need to chop my chocolate chunks, but I do need to chop my chocolate. So I'm going to just chop it into similar sized chunks as what's in my milk chocolate. I'm doing a mixture of the two. You could do whichever you choose. You could do all dark chocolate or all milk chocolate. It really doesn't matter. And it doesn't have to be expensive chocolate either. This was in my fridge, so that's what I'm using. But just use whatever chocolate you like. So we'll just give it a quick chop. Keep an eye on your cream while you're doing it, guys. We don't want it to burn or anything. Check our cream to see how it's doing. What we do is we give it a little swirl, take it off the heat. And if you can see steam coming off it, it's getting there. We just need it to be a little warmer. We don't want it too hot. I can see little bubbles starting to appear around the outside. I'm going to take it off the heat and I'm going to add all of the chocolate that I have. So that's my chocolate chip going in, all of it, and my dark chocolate. And we've got my chocolate here. So what we need to do now is wait for about 5 minutes just for the chocolate to start to melt before we stir it. So my chocolate and cream have been sitting together for about 5 minutes and I'm going to give it a stir. You need to stir it with a plastic spatula. Just give it a little stir, gently stir it. And what we're aiming for is it to come together into one even mixture. And you get this lovely glossy mixture, which bakers call a ganache. So I'm going to do two different things with it. You've got an option here. You can do this and pour it in, which is good, and then spread it out, which we're gonna do. You know, you can do that with all of it. You don't have to just do it with part of it like I'm doing here. So I'm gonna leave that bit to cool, and the other part I'm going to put into my stand mixer and leave to cool as well.
My ganache is now set. It's been sat here for just over an hour. So what I'm going to do is give it a good whisk to lighten it up a bit. So in it goes, and then set it off low. When I turn the electricity on, why do I always forget? And just keep going. Once it's loosened up, what we're going to do is add a little bit more cream. About 50 mils of cream into there. And we're going to mix that in gradually, like so. And if you see it pooling at the edges, just get a spatula and give it a wipe down at the edges. Right. And then just continue. There we go. Whisking, and be careful you don't over mix at this stage. Okay, if it's keeping its form, which it is now, all it needs is putting on your pie. Oops, excuse me. is putting on your pie. Now this seems to be keeping its shape, which is good. It's holding itself, it's stiff peaks, which is what we're after. Taking my whipped ganache, I'm just going to give it a bit of a fold. Now, it's your choice here. You can actually pipe this on. It's no problem at all to pipe, but as you know, I'm not a piper. So, I'm going to put this on freeform, as they say. So, little bits, just on top. And what I'm going to do is just spread it about. And you can use this for many things. Topping cakes, putting in the middle of cakes, making it into mousses. So to make it into chocolate pots, that's nice. So this size case would probably feed 10 people. You don't need a lot. As you can see, it would be lovely if it was piped on, but I'm not a piper, so we're going to do this right round the outside. But there is that, and then just to over egg the pudding, if it's going to be chocolatey, it might as well be chocolatey. So all you need is one square of your chocolate, not even that probably. So there's one square. So all I'm going to do with this bit of chocolate very quickly is just grate it on top. There you go. And it didn't even use the square. And there you have my chocolate tart. Enjoy.